Well, hello there, my game friends. This is your fabulous host, VACT here, and today I'm gonna play a game called Aegis Defenders, and it's a 16-bit tactical platformer that's set in a wonderful world full of magic and ancient technology. And the game is made by a developer called Guts Department. And Aegis Defenders just happens to be a, you know, big Kickstarter hit that collected over $140,000. And I tried the game last night, and I have to say that it's a mix of, well, everything and nothing pretty much. I mean, you get the Evangelion vibes going on, and then you get Valley of the Wind vibes, and you also get this mix of Chrono Trigger, Super Metroid, Zelda, and even Mega Man. So in short, Aegis Defenders is like the 16-bit perfection, pretty much. And just look at the graphics and just listen to the beautiful music. And I should also point out that I do not play Aegis Defenders with a control pad. I'm playing it with a keyboard. But I would most definitely recommend anyone that tries the demo or the full game later on to play it with a game controller, because the keyboard controllers are somewhat stiff, I have to say. It works, but it could be better. But that's pretty much it when it comes to the brief presentation, so to speak. And the actual gameplay is pretty darn, you know, mixed. I mean, you get like the Mega Man action kind of thing, and then you get the Metroid environment on top of that. And the graphics is like, I don't know, it feels like you're in an interactive painting in a kind of way. And just take a look at the enemies, for example. That the first time I saw them, I was like, okay, Super Metroid. So that was like a good, you know, the similarities in a way. And I also like the fact that you can actually play Age of the, you know, Aegis Defenders as a co-op kind of thing. I mean, right now I'm playing it by myself, but you can actually play it with a friend. And I think that would be a rather good thing to do. I mean, even though I play the game on the easiest level, it's rather hard, but I can just imagine how it would be if you play like on the hardest setting and actually try to, you know, complete the game with AI, you know, co-op person. Because trust me, when I get to the final stage on this level, you're gonna understand what I mean, because it's gonna get really hard, because you have to, like, as for example here, you can place torrents out wherever you want them, but you need to have enough resources to do so. But as you saw here, you can actually recycle everything and place it wherever you want it. But if you make a bad decision, Aegis Defenders will punish you like brutally. And this is the actual part of the game which I mentioned earlier, because now you're gonna get like totally overrun by bugs, monsters, and God knows what more. And this is the like Evangelion vibes that I spoke about. I don't know if you guys have watched that anime before, but you get super big robots going on there. And I also think I forgot to mention that you can switch between the characters in Aegis Defenders as you please. And this is the first wave. I think there's like 10 waves or something like that before the stage is over. So you basically have to survive. And not only survive, but if one single monster gets close to the robot or whatever it's supposed to be, then you're screwed. But luckily enough, there's like save points. And this is actually the part of the game that made me think about... The player phase, you get like 39 seconds to, you know, stock up on resources and, you know, place out all your defense, you know, buildings or weapons or whatever you have. You can also use like traps, blocks, well, whatever you got at your disposal. But as I was about to say, this actually made me think about, you know, when you do defense building in Command & Conquer, for example. That was actually the first thing that I came to think about when I started to do all the, you know, using the blocks and the torrents. Because I don't know if you guys have played, for example, Red Alert or Command & Conquer Tiberian Sun, for example. There's like a whole lot of different, you know, base defending kind of structures, you know, mini guns, flamethrowers, whatnot. And most of that stuff exists in Aegis Defenders as well. And now you're probably gonna understand what I mean with the difficulty setting, because it's enough that just one monster reaches the robot, the Evangelion robot, then you're screwed. And the thing is this, sure, you can restart from the last checkpoint, but all the stuff that you have placed out on the battlefield will be gone, so you have to do it from the very start again. And that's somewhat frustrating, because the truth is this, I had to like replay this, I think it was like 3 times, because if you don't plan this out in a good way from the very start, then your chances gonna be really slim that you're gonna survive to the 10th wave. And if you pay close attention to how I, you know, place stuff out on the battlefield, then you will see that I use it in a certain pattern. I also noticed that you can use, I think it's some kind of bug, but up here where I am now, if you jump in a certain way, you can get stuck with one of the characters, so you can use, it's almost like a rapid fire kind of bug, so you can easily take out, you're gonna see it soon, it's like flying monsters. That's a really big pain in the ass, because you can't, at least I don't know if you can, shoot up in different directions. So you have to stand on something to be able to shoot them. And here's the traps, which I've spoken of earlier. You get different kinds, you get like spikes, and you get a slow feel, which slows the enemies down. I will also be able to get like a explosive kind of trap. But I wouldn't recommend you to place them out, you know, like randomly, because you're gonna need to save them for the bigger monsters, so that when you see them, you just place them out in, you know, in the right time. Because if you place them out just randomly, then they might get activated by really weak, you know, enemies. So just if that's the case, they're just gonna waste it away. And as you might figure, all the traps and such cost resources. And if I'm not totally wrong, the explosive, well, I think I could call it a mine, they require quite a lot of both, I think it's called mana ore, and the other one is some kind of flower. Okay, now you get the player phase, and for some reason the player phase differs in time. I don't know why, but sometimes it's like 49 seconds and sometimes it's way above 40 seconds. And that's how you... that's a different kind of torrent. It actually uses laser. And I can actually slam enemies in the face with a gigantic hammer, but I'm gonna place the laser torrent here. And the player phase is almost over. And it's also really important that you stock up on resources, or else you're fucked, pretty much. And that's the explosive one that I mentioned. The only reason that I place it out on, you know, randomly is because I know that there's gonna be enemies coming that way. And that's the flying assholes, which I mentioned. You have to either jump, you know, up and down, or stand on something to be able to kill him. I would also recommend that you use you know, that slow down field, because then you get more time to kill them. And I actually don't think that your grandpa in the game have any like weapon that he can use to shoot enemies in the air. At least I haven't seen it yet. And those are a real pain in the ass because they can roll. Rock and rolla, so to speak. And they also push you backwards if they hit you. And it's also a really good idea to try to take out the flying assholes before anything else, because if they get beyond the end of the stage here, you can't actually reach them and shoot them. And then you're screwed. Because I think, I don't know if it's a bug, but they don't actually have to physically touch the robot. It's enough that they are like in a vertical line with the robot whatsoever, and it's over. So you get like no second chance or anything. And this would do the trick, I think. And it's also really good idea to place out, I don't know if it's bricks or boxes or whatever, but if you put it on the ground, then they have to break it before they can continue. So use whatever you get to your disposal and use it, you know, in a smart kind of way. Now it's time for the fourth wave, so there's like six more to go. And that's the big dudes that I talked about. They take like a whole shitload of hits to kill. And I think I actually saw some kind of bug yesterday, because one of them just, you know, vanished. And for some reason it came to the other side of the screen. I don't know if it was a bug or whatever, but I didn't kill it. It just like disappeared and then it came to the other side. I don't know if it was like a special ability or whatnot. But they can also eat stuff that you have placed out if they get close enough. Then they do some kind of, I don't know, Pokemon move. They just like nom 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 and then it's gone. Gone for life. This is starting to get rather intense. So I'm gonna use this. So I'm gonna slow this bastard down here. And as you can see, the laser can't reach that far. So sometimes you have to help it, you know, a bit. Because the torrents can also be destroyed if they get hit, you know, too many times. And I can honestly say that if your torrents get broke down, then restart, because you're not gonna have any time to build everything. And that's how I meant, like, how to use the explosives. You just place them out just in front of the big enemies. Kind of like a mine, in a way. And now it's... Christ, there's like not much time left. And you have to like constantly restock resources. And it's always like a time against the clock. But you know what? That's what make Aegis Defenders kind of unique. I mean, you mix all these things. The Mega Man, Super Metroid action, and the defense building. And then you got like the Metal Slug kind of shooting action kind of thing. So it's a very nice mix of everything, pretty much. But I'm of course, you know, curious to see what the full version of Aegis Defenders will be, you know, all about. Or what it will be like. Because this is just like a fragment of the full thing. And I honestly, the first time I played this, I thought like, oh Christ, I'm gonna have to, you know, defeat this gigantic robot boss, but that was not the case. You're gonna see what I mean when I'm done with the stage. Because that made me think like, okay. Because you get not... the first time I played I had like very little life and almost no resources. Then I thought like, okay, there's gonna be a big boss battle now. So my odds wasn't exactly the best. I thought that I would die a brutal death. And I think it doesn't like... I think it's enough that one of the characters die. So if you don't help your granddad or vice versa, then you're screwed as well. So you have to like... you know, act really fast. Think fast and act fast. Okay, now it's player face again. Try to stack up. And if I'm not totally wrong, I think it's like wave 9 or 10. Then there's just gonna be like a Zerg rush from hell. And I'm not talking about like one rush just from one side. I'm talking about the rush from both sides. It's gonna be total overkill. So I'm gonna see if I can manage to survive all the way. And as you may have noticed at the very start of the game, I chose to play on the easy level, because when I played on normal, I was pretty much almost dead when I finished it. But I honestly don't know if there's gonna... if the difficulty levels gonna, you know, affect anything more but the difficulty setting, if you know what I mean, if there's gonna be like... alternative endings based on what kind of difficulty level you choose. But so far I don't think that's the case. And see how this is going. Okay, now I'm supposed to go to the other side. And so far I have to say that those flying things are the enemies that I hate the most. Because I have still not figured out a way that I can shoot any other direction than forward. I just wish that you can shoot up or pretty much any direction you want, but I don't know if that's something that, you know, the Guts Department team are working on, because I find it somewhat strange if you wouldn't be able to shoot any angle you want. And that's the bug that I talked about. I'm just hovering in the air. And that guy tries to destroy my block, so I'm gonna stop him. And there's one of those, I don't know, blobs, or what the hell I'm supposed to call them. It kind of reminds of those blobs from, I think it's Lufia or Shining Force. Just gigantic blobs that eats everything that comes in their way. Yes, we're gonna place another one here. Cock-blocking, in a kind of way. I think the next wave is gonna be like the first really hard one. No, okay, screw that then. I mean, I thought for myself, what if there was like a bug that... the, you know, the resources wouldn't start to regenerate, then you would also be pretty screwed. Because there's no way in hell that you could survive if you didn't get, like, new resources throughout the battle. And one thing that would make the game even harder if you had, like, limited ammo disposal. That would be, like, the overkill... you know, difficulty setting. You got no regenerated ammo and you got like a limited setting of ammo. Kind of like I watched a angry video game nerd video about Alien 3, the endless game. What a piece of shit that was. God damn. But I can't say that I liked the Mega Drive version that much more. I still remember how sad I was as a kid that I bought Alien 3 for the Mega Drive. That was probably the worst game that I have ever bought to this very day. I actually went back to the video game store just the day after and returned it. It was that fucking bad. I mean, I thought it would be something like, you know, action and all that, but it was just running around and... the same backgrounds, the same everything. It was boring as hell. And thankfully enough, Aegis Defenders ain't nothing like Alien 3. Nope. It's actually... well, at least there's no like end of the game for... well, not finished the game, so I think, but... I have to say that it's one of the best in the making in the games that I have played for this year. Okay, now I can't even jump up there, but screw it. But for some reason my old grandpa can get up on the, well, platform or whatever it's supposed to be. Stone platform. Okay, I got a lot of blow roses, or what it's supposed to be. Some kind of power source. And now I think it's gonna be like total overkill with enemies. Okay, that's a new one. I placed the traps inside the, you know, the boxes. So it's gonna be like a very unpleasant Christmas gift. Okay, it starts off with a gigantic blob, and my grandpa just sits there with his ass. Nice. And more flying things. Looks like some kind of, I don't know, leech. Flying leech. Those slowdowns are a really great weapon against these. So I can just imagine how it is if you get like two slowdown power fields on the same place, pretty much. That's a really good, like, tactical move to do. Oh great, another blob. Blob from hell. I wonder how much, you know, hit points the blobs has. I mean, it feels like it's several hundred. Oh great, they fucking broke it. But my hover bug there took care of the problem. I think there's like two or three waves left now. See if I can actually manage to survive all the way through. Okay, see if the lasers can do some wonders with the blob. Oh yes. Oh shit, they tried to break it. Yep, stand on the box. That's a pro tip right there. And suitably enough, there's actually, I think it's snowing in the game. I just noticed that. I mean, it's Christmas and all. Pretty good timing. Okay, now he's almost up. Okay, I'm gonna place out everything that I have. That's gonna protect the laser torrents, but I need to go up and place up some boxes here as well. Because if they break both of them, then I can't reach the resource on top. On the top platform. And here I have to build some as well. ...30 seconds may sound much, but trust me, it ain't that much. At least not in Aegis Defenders. It runs out less, you know, really fast. So think fast and act fast. Multitasking, so to speak. In real time, even. You see what I mean? Now it starts. The goddamn Zerg rush from hell. Okay, gonna take all this. And it's close to the very end now. See if I can take a stand and stay alive. This made me think about the episode from, I think it's called Tour of Duty. It's like a Vietnam TV series. There's an episode when the guys of the series has to defend a base in Vietnam called Ladybird. And not to spoil anything for you guys, but let's just say that there's nothing left of Ladybird at the very end of the episode. This is pretty much how I feel at this very moment. There's like monsters and shit coming out of nowhere and just attacking me from all angles. Ladybird part fucking 2, pretty much. Just gonna see. I think there's one last push by the monsters. I wonder how many monsters I have killed. It has to be like, I don't know, plus 100. So it's like kill frenzy mode. Yes, there's a last time. One more time, as Daft Punk would have said. Okay, this is the final push by the monsters. That was a really good idea to put the power field there, but I can't go up there. Screw that. And Grandpa tries to kill a, I don't know, a ghost or something. Oh yeah, more flying bastards. Even two of them. And I thought I heard or saw a blob there, but I could be wrong. Nope, was nothing. Not this time. Gonna try to take this. Do a really big jump. There's the blob. Come here, blobby. Gonna give you some diet advices here. By dying, so you don't have to worry about, you know, diet problems. Okay, one more flying thing. A flying leech. Can stack up. Ah, oh, crap, I missed that one. Ah, oh, screw it. Was that everything? No. And I still can't get up there. I think this is the final push. Oh, great. Oh, did you see that? He just ate it. Like it was some Christmas candy box or something. And look at that, it's gone. Okay, I ate the other one as well. Oh, great. Now I can't reach that. Screw it. Oh, another one. Gonna use the hover bug here. You actually get the chance to do, like, out the fire. Rapid fire. Oh, there we go. Fight back, yeah. Okay, it needs a lot of power, I guess. Ah, yes, the energy stones. I used one to start it or boot it up. And this was actually the very end. So I hope you liked it, people. And just like always, feel free to subscribe. And of course, comment if you want to. So just take care, people. This is VX signing out. Bye-bye.